Hi everyone, my name is Esther and I'm back for another sewing tutorial with Loanland Kits. Today we're going to be sewing the sweater romper. It is a really cute pattern of an oversized sweater with or without a hood, and then it's got little snap studs across the bottom so that you can pin them up under bum. There are some variations you can do with this pattern, so like I said, you can do it with or without the hood. I don't know why I'm touching my hair. With or without a hood, you can add a little front pocket, you can even add a cinched in waist, and there are instructions for how to do that when you purchase this online. You should definitely have a look at some of the really cute pics that are on the website. I'll show you a few here that just give you inspiration for how this sweater looks. Oh no, not me, the phone. Anyway, you can have a look online as well as Instagram at Loanland Kits to find much more inspiration. I decided to use this light cotton terry. So that's the underside and that's the right side. And I used a gray rib for the cuffs. And this is how it turned out. It's so cute and it's got the little snap studs under here. Don't be afraid of using snap studs because this is only my second time using them. I followed the instructions on the packet. You can purchase them in little packets from sewing stores, or you can order them online from Amazon or wherever you get your sewing supplies. Once you get the hang of them, they're not too difficult. You just need a hammer and a little bit of practice. And then you've got some really cute press studs that open and close quite easily to fasten onto bub. There is some information on fabric choice in the instructions, but I would really love to do this sweater romper in like a thick fleece or something that's really cozy for winter. Here in Australia, I'm going into summer, so that didn't really make sense, which is why I chose a very lightweight cotton terry. Whereas if you're in many other places in the world, you are likely going into some very cold weather, and a beautiful thick fleece would just be amazing with this pattern. The only thing you have to be careful of is when you're attaching these press studs, that when you get thick fabric, it can be more difficult to attach those. So just take that into account when you're choosing your fabric. Otherwise, you can choose pretty much any fabric, any stretchy fabric, should I mention, any sort of stretchy fabric for this sweater romper. Having said that, if you make it oversized enough, I reckon you could get away with doing a woven non-stretchy fabric. I'm pretty tempted to try it because I think it would be so cute in something like a linen, a very unique look. I might try my hand at it, but we'll see how we go. If you end up sewing your own version of the sweater romper, we would love to see it. Tag us on Instagram, hashtag Loanland Kits. We love seeing all of these cute little people wearing these Loanland Kits patterns. So jump on there and tag us to show us your latest project. Let's get started.
Okay, so I followed the instructions to download my paper pattern pieces and I've pieced paper pattern pieces and I've pieced them all together according to the instructions. Now I'm just putting aside the pattern pieces I won't need since I'm doing the hooded version and I am not putting a pocket on. The only adjustment that I'm doing, or a little, it's not really a hack, what I like to do is I like to pin my front and back pieces together since they are actually almost identical except for the neckline. So I actually piece them together so that I can cut them both as a pair. Seeing as I'm cutting the sleeve as a pair as well, I find that this is easier, but if you do the same, you just have to be careful to cut the back neckline first because the back neckline is higher, and then after you've done that, then you can cut the front neckline. Now I can cut out all my fabric pieces. This is a little scrap piece of ribbing that I had left over and it's about a centimeter short, but I'm going to use it anyway because I don't want to waste. I try to use up my scraps as much as possible, so I'm just trimming that to size. Remember to be careful if you're using pins because they can leave little holes in stretch fabrics. So just be very careful that your pins are very sharp, or you can use little sewing clips instead. Because I'm using a stretch fabric, I need a stretch stitch while I'm sewing, so I'm going to use my overlocker or serger. If you don't have one, you can use a regular sewing machine on a zigzag stitch. If you're not sure how to do that, Google a tutorial on how to use your zigzag stitch for stretch fabric. There are heaps of videos out there that can explain it better than I can. So I'll begin by sewing the hood, the shoulder seams, and the sleeve cuffs. All of my pieces are right sides of the fabric together, and my sleeve cuffs are folded in half in the same direction as the ribbing. I'll serge them all in one go because I hate going back and forth to my machine, so I'll do all those seams all at once. Next, I'm going to reinforce this crotch seam where the snap studs are going to go with just a little bit of fusible interfacing. So this is a really lightweight interfacing that uses heat to bond to the fabric. I'm going to just cut these two really small strips. This is not essential, but I would recommend if you're using a lighter fabric to do so, so that you just give some extra strength to the fabric so that it doesn't tear when you insert those press studs. While I'm at the iron, I'm also going to press open the hood seam. So just give it a nice press so that the seam is open and it's sitting nice and flat. And I'm going to fold up the edge of the hood about 1.3 centimeters. I believe it's half an inch. That's the seam allowance that's allowed. Pressing that up because we're going to hem the edge of the hood as the next step. So you can use a cover stitch if you have one, and you can also use some of the other stitch options on a regular sewing machine to hem that edge of your hood. But I get a little intimidated by those stitches, so whenever I can, I try to get away with just overlocking or serging that edge and then using a straight stitch machine. You do have to be careful if you're using the straight stitch on a stretch fabric though. A good way to check is to see how much stretch you actually need on that particular seam. In this particular part of the hood, you don't really need stretch, which is why I can get away with using a straight stitch. So I serged that edge and then I turned it up and then I sewed it using a straight stitch sewing machine. Next up, we're going to attach the sleeves. So I've opened up my bodice and we've already sewn the shoulder seams. So what I'm going to do is fold my sleeve in half, put a little marking, and line that halfway mark up with the shoulder seam. Pop the right sides together as always, and if you're using pins, again be careful, or otherwise use clips, and we'll serge straight across this edge. Do the same for the other sleeve, and then we will move on to the hood. So with my hood the right way out, I'm going to line up the center of that hood with the center back, so the middle part of the back neck. The right sides of your fabric should be together and use a pin or a clip to keep those in place. Now find the center front of your front neck. So you can do that by folding the neck in half and finding the middle point. And find the front pieces of your hood and bring them towards that center front point. I'm going to overlap my hood pieces by about 1 centimeter at that center front. It'll just make the finish a bit nicer, cleaner, and give it a little bit of extra strength. Once you've done that, you can ease the rest of the hood in to fit with the rest of the neck. Once you've got it all in there, it will make sense, so trust the process. While I'm serging, I'll also start from the hem of the armhole and serge all down the side seams of both sides. Now to attach the binding to the leg opening, open up your bodice like this so that the side seams are easily accessible and everything's sitting nice and flat. Fold your binding piece in half, make sure that the right side of your binding is on the outside, and mark the center point of the binding so that you can match that up with the side seam. The binding should be in contact with the right side of your sweater, and once that's pinned in place, you can pull the binding and stretch it all the way down to the crotch. Pin that in place and then stretch the binding out to distribute it evenly along the entire leg opening. Do the same to the other side. Before I serge that, I'm going to sew my cuffs in as well. So I'm going to fold my arm cuff pieces in half. Sorry, my camera just missed the important part of the visual here. I've just folded it in half and I'm trying to get that seam on the inside nice and flat. And then I'm going to tuck that whole cuff inside the sleeve. So again, the right sides of your fabric should always be together. And I'm going to place the seams of the cuff close to the seams of the sweater, but not on top because that'll make the fabric too thick. And I don't like pushing things through my machine that are, you know, 8 layers thick. So I just pop it a little bit to the side. I'll stretch the binding out to fit the cuff and then I'll pin it in place. Do the same for the other sleeve and then we're ready to serge. once serged, this is what the leg opening should look like. Nice and neat, nice and stretchy. And before we do the press studs, I've just serged straight across that crotch line. It's not called a crotch line. I don't know what to call that seam. I've serged straight across. Then I'll fold it up 1 inch and press that down and then use a straight stitch to sew straight across there. If you aren't lazy like I am, it's probably a good idea to press all of your seams as you go. So each time you sew a seam, you should press it so that it's nice and flat. You'll get a much nicer outcome as your final product. But otherwise, if you're a bit lazy like I am, you can try and get in there with your iron and give all your seams a press because we're nearly done. I've flipped my sweater the right way out and then I'm going to do 3 press studs across the crotch. These are some that I already had, so of course if you already have some, use those. Otherwise, there are heaps that you can buy online. They might differ a little bit in how you fasten them, so I'm not going to talk you through that. They should come with pretty clear instructions, although it took me a few goes. I think I got scarred from a previous project that I did where I totally stuffed it up, so I do recommend that you do a test run or do a few if you need to gain a bit of confidence so that you have a very good idea and you don't muck up your final product when you are putting these on. And there you have it. Your sweater romper is complete.
So there we go, another successful little sew up of a lowland pattern. I'm really loving these lowland kids patterns. I have a little bub, but I haven't actually sewn many things for her at all. So this is giving me a really good chance to get stuck in and make her a little wardrobe that it's unique. I can add some little applique later on if I feel like it. Go back to the lowland kids Instagram and find some inspiration if you're needing some. I'm sure you'll find some styles or some like patterns that'll get your mind ticking as to what you can sew. You can find all the patterns online. Go to lowlandkids.com and you'll find everything you need there. I hope that this video was helpful for you. If there was anything that was unclear, feel free to leave a question in the comments and we'll do our best to get back to you. And if you had any suggestions for patterns that you would like to see me do in the future videos, leave that in the comments as well. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching and I will see you again in another video soon. Bye!